when you are cleaning your raw data, you will want to check for outliers, particularly multivariate outliers, because they can really mess up your analysis. We are going to dive deeper into how to identify multivariate outliers using a Mahalanobis distance test in SPSS.
This is an abbreviated video for those of you who just want to know how to conduct a Mahalanobis distance test in SPSS. If you want fuller explanation about the multivariate outliers, including troubleshooting common problems, please check out the full video. For this assignment, we will be working with the dataset Mahalanobis_ph.sav. Now, to be clear, the Mahalanobis test does not require a dependent variable. However, the only way to run a Mahalanobis test in SPSS is by using a regression analysis. And the only way to run a regression analysis in SPSS is to specify a dependent variable of some kind. We will completely ignore the regression output, but we still need to have some kind of continuous variable to use as a DV. I will use the random ID number as a dependent variable. Go to Analyze, Regression, Linear. We will begin by moving our ID number or other random continuous variable into the dependent variable box. Next, we need all of the variables that we will use in our analysis and that may contain multivariate outliers. Notice that we have 8 scales, or 8 variables. These scales were each created by taking the mean of 3 items that were written to measure that construct. Those individual items have been removed from this dataset for simplicity. Move our 8 variables into the independent variables box. Remember that we're going to ignore the regression output, so there is nothing to set or adjust in the output, but there is one test that we want, and it's found under the Save button. The Save menu does not add anything to the output, but instead, it does something to the variables and then saves those results to your dataset. Under Distances, click Mahalanobis. This will save the results of the Mahalanobis test to our data. Click Continue, and then OK. The output window pops up, but we do not need anything in this output. So we will just close the window, and we will ignore all of this. Instead, we are going to focus on the data. In Data View, in our SPSS dataset, you will notice that we have a new variable, MAH_1. Those are the Mahalanobis scores that SPSS saved for us. Each case has its own Mahalanobis score. It tells us the distance between it and the other scores. Unfortunately, this does not tell us enough. We want to know the probability that a particular case would be this distance just by chance. To interpret the Mahalanobis scores, we are going to convert those Mahalanobis distance values into probabilities. And to do that, we are going to create a new variable. In SPSS, go to Transform, Compute Variable. In the Target Variable box, type PMAH_1. This will stand for the probability of the MAH1, aka the Mahalanobis score. Under Function Group, select the group CDF and Non-Central CDF. These are the cumulative distribution functions for various distributions. We want chi-square, so select CDF chi-square. This will calculate the probability of a variable which follows the chi-square distribution, such as the Mahalanobis test. We need 2 values here. First, we need the variable name, which is MAH1. And then we need the degrees of freedom, which is the number of variables, or 8. And there's one more thing to do. Because the CDF function in SPSS computes cumulative probability from the left end of the distribution. We actually want the inverse of this probability. So we will subtract the whole thing from 1 to obtain the probability in the upper tail of the distribution. Click OK. In the data set, we only have 2 decimals, so let's go back to the variables, which you can do by double-clicking on the name of the variable, and we will increase the decimal points to 4. Now, return to the data, again by double-clicking on the name of the variable. We want to see the smallest Mahalanobis probabilities at the top of the column. Right-click, or control-click on Mac, and sort ascending. You will now examine each of the Mahalanobis values and eliminate those that have a probability of less than p equals 0.001. And here is where you have some decisions to make. Clearly, this first one is way below 0.001. It is a multivariate outlier and it should be removed. The second one is exactly 0.001. I would remove that one as well. This one is slightly above 0.001, but I left it in my data set and it still caused problems later, so I would recommend removing this one as well. These are the kinds of decisions that you have to make when you do exploratory data analysis. When you write up your results for data cleaning, you can include a statement like this. Data were assessed for multivariate outliers using a Mahalanobis distance test, Tabachnick and Fidell, 2013. 3 multivariate outliers were identified and removed. Or, no multivariate outliers were identified.